Assalamu alaikum. Today is session number third of our level 2 Aqeedah. Rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri wa hlul uqdatam min lisani yafqahu qawli. Before we start today's session, I want to ask you a few questions here. And as an activity, I want you to find an answer for it. The two questions are, is it permissible for me to visit Taj Mahal? Okay, I'll write the questions if you want. Is it permissible for me to visit Taj Mahal? Secondly, is it permissible for me to visit Karbala? You have to give your reasons, okay?
Hello?
Yes, I'm typing. It's an homework activity for you. So find out the answers with reason and send it to me in personal. Okay?
Inshallah.
Okay. All right. Fine. So yesterday we completed the visiting of graves. And we have to begin with the next chapter, which is some of this Ummah worships Authan, idols. Now what is Al-Wathan? The Arabic word Authan stands for anything worshipped other than the real God, which is Allah. That is all the false deities. So basically it is... Yes?
Assalamu alaikum. Wa, and Noon?
Wasa and Noon, Wathana, yeah, the Tha.
Okay, three dots Tha, huh?
Yeah.
Watham.
Yeah.
Okay.
I am still looking for the Arabic text, but inshallah I will confirm. Most probably it is that only. I have English version here. We'll have to go back to the ayah to check it anyways. I will confirm inshallah. Okay. So any deities or the statues or the idols that is worshipped is called Wathan. Now in general, the word Wathan covers a very wide range of images and idols and all that is worshipped besides Allah Azza wa Jal. Now there is another word or another terminology which is called As-Sanam. So what is the difference between Al-Wathan and As-Sanam? As for reality, As-Sanam is set as the statue of a human or an animal, that is a living thing. As for Wathan, it is anything worshipped besides Allah. So a grave is a Wathan, and all the trees and stones, etc., are Authan. Whereas a Sanam is a statue of an animal or a human being, yani any living thing statue. So that's the difference between Al Wathan and a Sanam. Now, can someone who says La ilaha illallah become a mushrik? Answer that, please. Can someone who says La ilaha illallah become a mushrik? Please unmute and answer with reasons. Yes, Iman.
No, nothing by mistake.
Okay, no, I thought you want to answer that question.
Can someone become a mushrik, shirk karna yani?
Yeah.
So, didn't understand your question exactly, because there are people who are doing shirk. I mean, when you say la ilaha illallah, definitely you cannot do shirk. Then la ilaha illallah ka wo nahi hai. But people, they are doing it. So I didn't get your question.
No, actually, no, honestly,
like
even if they say and they're not doing it with ikhlas, maybe then it is what I understand.
Actually, Jumana, you answered the question when you were asking about the clarification. I asked you, can a person who says La ilaha illallah can become a mushrik? The answer to that will be yes, if he commits shirk. Right?
Yeah, we actually, this is what I understood, but
yeah, this is what I asked actually. That
okay,
it is easy for anyone, even if the person claims to be a Muslim, even if a person claims to have said the wordings of Shahada, but in reality, Nauzubillah, anybody can become a mushrik if he commits shirk, right?
Ah, right.
Surah number 4, ayah number 51. Have you not seen those who were given a portion of the scripture? They believe in Al-Jibt and At-Taghut. Now, there are some terminologies which I want you to remember. Like how we spoke about Al-Wathan and Sanam. In the previous chapters in level 1, we spoke about Jibt and Taghut, if you remember. I will again quickly go through what is the Jibt and Taghut. Jibt, Ad-Jibt we call it. General term for anything that contains an opposition to the commands of Allah Azawajal and his messengers in beliefs. Alhamdulillah. It may be fortune telling. It may be fortune telling, soothsaying, or sorcery. In general, it means falsehood and evil things. I again repeat, a jibt will be anything that contains an opposition to the commands of Allah Azawajal and the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Example, fortune telling, soothsaying, or sorcery. In general, it means falsehood and evil things. Now that is Ajibt. Okay. And then Taghut, we have already discussed this in detail. That by which the slave transgresses his limit, such as something that is worshipped or obeyed in exaggeration. That becomes Taghut. Example, Isa alayhi salam. Okay, what the Jews, what the Christians did with Isa alayhi salam, he made him a Taghut. He himself was not a Taghut, but these people exaggerated in terms of obeying and worshipping and glorifying, that they raised him from the level of messenger to the level of God. So that's, they made him Taghut. So the four terminologies for today for you to remember is Al-Wathan, As-Sanam, Ajibt, and At-Taghut in regards to Aqidah level 2. Just remember them and there shouldn't be a mix-up. So Al-Wathan is the image and idols that is worshipped besides Allah. As-Sanam is anything which is a living thing idol. Example, animals, humans, etc. Ajibt is anything that is in opposition of Allah's and Messenger's command, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And At-Taghut is where there is a transgression in terms of obeying or worshipping. Very clear, there is no confusion. All of you are okay with this? Any explanation required in that?
No, I think it's okay.
Simple, huh? All right. So, who were given a portion of the scripture? Of course, Yahud or Nasara. Belief in Jibt and Taghut in this context means agreeing with those who believed in them, even though they knew that it was falsehood. Yani, we have to understand very clearly every time, whenever we are studying Aqeedah, the affirmation and negation go hand in hand. Like for us, we can never have something called I will agree that there is no other God but Allah Azza wa Jal. But if I'm not rejecting the other gods, that means I am not completing or not perfecting my Tawheed. Because even Yahud and Nasara were of the belief that they believe that Allah Azza wa Jal is the only one, but they did not reject the other gods. You affirm that, okay, you are affirming Allah Azza wa Jal is the only Lord, but you are not rejecting the other God. For us to be on the right aqidah, we have to do the affirmation and the rejection at the same time. That is the point where we will achieve the Aqidah Tawheed level. So it is very, very important that one affirms and rejects at the same time. All right. So what happens is that these people, even though they knew what is the truth, the Yahud and Nasara knew that Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is the right messenger. They knew Allah Azza wa Jal is the Lord, but still they deny it. Almighty Allah Azza wa Jal asks His Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam to consider the case of the Jews and the Christians. Though they were given a portion of the divine scripture in which both the truth and falsehood was clearly demonstrated, they still believe in falsehood, such as idolatry, soothsaying and sorcery in submission to the satanic insinuations. Now, if we take those examples, like abhi agar hum apni life mein real example le le, you will see people around you. I have seen people around in my family जो दरगाह वगैरह पे जाते हैं उनका बिलीफ सिस्टम जो है वो शेकी है, नॉलेज एंड अवेयरनेस की कमी है. आप उनके सामने, इनफैक्ट यस्टरडे वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट इट, आप उनके सामने एविडेंसेस रखें, बड़े प्यार से, बड़े तरीके से, बड़े विजडम के साथ आप उनको अप्रोच करें, येट दे विल डिनाई इट. आप देखेंगे कि वो इतने ज्यादा अपने बिलीफ, रॉन्ग बिलीफ और फॉल्सहुड में उनका जो यकीन होता है वो इतना स्टॉन्च होता है दैट इट बिकम्स रियली डिफिकल्ट. वो मरने मारने पर आ जाएंगे, वो आपसे रिश्ता तोड़ने पर आ जाएंगे, लेकिन वो झूठ का साथ नहीं छोड़ेंगे, वो फॉल्सहुड को नहीं छोड़ेंगे. आई मीन इट इज वियर्ड एक्चुअली. आई डोंट नो हाउ कैन समबडी डिनाई कुरानिक वर्सेस एंड वर्ड्स ऑफ मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम एंड गो बिहाइंड समथिंग बेसलेस. एंड उनको ये भी पता अच्छी तरह से कि इसमें नुकसान है, इसमें फायदा नहीं है. लाइक वी डिस्कस्ड यस्टरडे दैट हाउ इफ यू आर burning a light and then the insects and the moths, the bugs are coming, getting attracted towards it. They are getting killed by it, yet it cannot stop it. That is the reason we have to be very firm, but at the same time we should know where to draw the line. Like I wouldn't say that you go on cutting your relationships with people. I wouldn't say that you go on picking up fights with everyone, because end of the day you will be boycotted. End of the day, you will be boycotted. But I would definitely ask you to be firm, to have aapke andar jo belief hai na, usko aap strong rakhein. Aap jo kar rahe ho, don't get influenced by them. Just to please them, don't get influenced by them. Keep your stand very strong and firm and make sincere dua for such relatives and family members. But don't follow them. My sincere request is don't follow them. Jahan mauka mile, you continuously keep on teaching and preaching about Aqidah Tawheed, but don't follow them. Don't fall weak, don't follow them, and exercise wisdom. Hikmat aur basirat ke saath aap approach karenge, jahalat ke saath mein. And as I always say, the only power, subhanallah, that we have in our hands are two, according to me. One is the power of dua, and second is the power of knowledge. So gain knowledge. The more you gain knowledge, आपकी बात में, आपके actions में एक अलग किस्म का weightage आएगा. So rather than arguing on silly things without proper knowledge, the best way is to gain knowledge and continuously make dua for such people, because they are your loved ones. You don't want to see any of your loved ones burning because of that one silly act. So make sure you keep on making dua and gaining knowledge. ये दो चीज कभी ज़िंदगी में नहीं छोड़ना, इंशाअल्लाह ताला. Since those given a portion of the scripture believe in Jibt and Tawhid, it does not seem far-fetched that some Muslims who were given the noble Quran worship Jibt and Tawhid too. Yani dekha jaye to jis cheez se mana kiya jata hai usi ke andar log zyada ghus jate hain. Ab jab baar baar kaha gaya hai Quranic verse mein, surah number 4 verse 51, that they were given the scriptures yet they believed in Jibt and Tawhid. So Quran is also word of Allah, which is the final word of Allah, in fact. So people who received the final word of Allah is also again falling in the trap of Jibt and Tawhid. And actually it's happening. We can see it around. May Allah protect us. The Prophet informs in a coming hadith, what happened among the nations before us will happen in this ummah too. things like building shrines and making tawaf and circulating around the graves, celebrating the birthdays of the prophets, calling the dead and slaughtering for them. All this and more had already happened in this ummah. Already happened, and again it is happening, and we don't know till where it will happen. May Allah protect us from all of these and our loved ones too. Another verse, another surah, surah number 5, verse number 60. Say, shall I inform you of something worse than that as penalty from Allah Azzawajal? It is that of those whom Allah has cursed and with whom He became angry, and He transformed some of them into apes and pigs and slaves of a taghut. Those are worse in position and further astray from the sound way. Again, I keep telling you that the words like curse, whenever in a hadith we hear the word that Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam cursed somebody, then again in the Quranic verses we hear that Allah cursed somebody. This is an indication that it is a very stern warning. Bahut ziyada strong warning hai. And we have been asked, it is a sign for us to stay away from that activity. Us amal se humko bachna hai. So what is that? What is worse than that? What is worse than your false accusation of the Prophet and his followers, as you said about them? Never have we seen worse than you. Curse, yani deprived of Allah's mercy, made of them apes. It refers to the Sabbath breakers from whom the Jews, if you know this kissa, ke ek unko fishing ke liye mana kiya gaya tha, ki they should be not doing it on Sabbath. But un logon ne kya hai ke jaal saazi ki, aur ek din jis din mana kiya hua tha, us din jaal laga dete the machhi ka, and then phir वो जो कमांड था उसको फॉलो नहीं करते थे. तो आउट ऑफ एंगर अल्लाह कन्वर्टेड देम इनटू एप्स एंड पिग्स. ये सबात का किस्सा उसको कहते हैं, और बहुत क्लियरली कुरान में मेंशन है. इफ यू गेट अ चांस प्लीज रीड द तफसीर. आई कीप गिविंग यू द रेफरेंसेस ताकि आप थोड़ा टाइम निकाल के गो बैक एंड इन्वेस्ट योर टाइम इन सम रिसर्च एंड रीड इट. यू विल एंजॉय एंड यू कैन कनेक्ट टू द टॉपिक देन बेटर.
Can you tell again this, which verse number again?
Surah 5, verse number 6. I'll type it for you one second.
Okay. Sabbath, okay.
Okay. Okay. So read that. And inshallah, you will get to know how people try to act smart. Yani, aap imagine karein, hum logon ki itni aukaat nahi hai ki hum humare creator ko jhansa de. हमारी इतनी दिमाग और इतनी चालाकी नहीं है. आप कहीं से भी अपने आप को तसल्ली देने के लिए चीट करने की कोशिश करें, लेकिन आप फंसोगे जरूर. देयर इज नो पॉइंट, यू कैन नॉट डू दैट. यानी हम लोग अगर दुनियावी टर्म्स में देखें, कैन वी चीट अवर पेरेंट्स, कैन वी चीट अवर टीचर्स? यस, टू एन एक्सटेंट यू माइट डू इट आउट ऑफ बींग नाइव और इनोसेंट और बींग मिस्चीवियस और समथिंग लाइक दैट. बट आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट कि आप जो है सुपरसीड नहीं कर सकते. आप अपने पेरेंट्स को सुपरसीड नहीं कर सकते. आप अपने टीचर्स को सुपरसीड नहीं कर सकते. तो आप अगर फॉर द टाइम बीइंग कुछ हद तक अगर आप कोई चीट करने में कामयाब भी हो जा रहे हैं, तो डोंट बी अंडर द इन्फ्लुएंस दैट दिस कैन गो लॉन्ग. एज वी ऑल नो, अल्लाह इज वॉचिंग ऑल द टाइम. द डीड्स आर गेटिंग रिकॉर्डेड. आपके वर्ड्स, आपके एक्शन, आपके थॉट्स, आपको हमेशा सोचना है इस चीज को कि यू कैन नॉट डू हिलाबाजी. यू कैन नॉट एक्ट स्मार्ट इन फ्रंट ऑफ अवर लॉर्ड. He knows inside out. आपके दिल और दिमाग में क्या चल रहा है. आप दुनिया को फेक कर सकते हो, आप अल्लाह को नहीं फेक कर सकते. तो इस चक्कर में कभी मत फंसना. Always consider black as black and white as white. Don't try to walk on the grey shade and think very smart of yourself. Our religion is about submission and humility. We have to submit ourselves inside out, complete 100%. So don't ever think you can outsmart your Lord. You can never do that in anything of religion, and of course in dunya as well. So since they were among the people of the book, those who worship Tawud besides Allah, some of the Muslim Ummah will be doing the same. Are the modern apes the descendants of those Jews? No. The Prophet ﷺ said, verily Allah did not cause the race of those who suffered metamorphosis to grow, or they were not survived by young ones, monkeys and swines had been in existence even before. And wo jo theory thi na ki human have evolved from apes and monkeys, or maybe this is what wahan se unki nasal shuru hui, aisa kuch bhi nahi hai. It was only pertaining to that particular generation, and that is it. It is not necessary to practice jipt and takut to be held a disbeliever. The mere acceptance of such practices turns a person to disbelief, even though he abhors them. Ek bahut important point yahan par note karna hai. Just acceptance of such practices will turn a person to disbelief. Disbelief is kufr, right? Agar aapne, being a Muslim, being a person of shahadatain, agar aap ye evil practices ko accept kar lete hain, like for example, let me give you an example. Some of you might not like what I say, but I have to say what I have to say. For example, aap ek apne, because we come from India, we have these things happening and we take it very lightly. किसी की घर में गणपति की पूजा है, आप चले गए उनके, उनको क्या कहते हैं, एनकरेज, आपको उन्होंने इनवाइट किया और आप उनकी फेस्टिविटी में चले गए, भाई भाईचारगी रखनी है, सबसे रिश्ता बना के रखना है, और आप उनकी वो जो पूजा वगैरह होती, आरती होती, उसमें आप चले गए, आपने कुछ किया नहीं, आप बस शरीक हो गए. यू थिंक इट्स अ राइट एक्ट? आंसर मी. You can
no.
You're not
because
doing
that way you're encouraging them that we believe in whatever you are doing as well,
right? It's, it means a mere acceptance, because aapki shirkat hi acceptance ban jati hai. Abhi log jo hai bahut coolly isko bada light lete hain. They participate in the Christmas, they participate in Diwali. Yani aap dekhen, in matters of aqeedah you cannot show any acceptance in any form, not even by congratulating them, not even by eating what they sacrifice and do stuff. You cannot participate in all those. Why? Because then indirectly you are showing your acceptance, and just by showing the acceptance you are committing kufr, and slowly and eventually anozbilla you will get out of the folds of Islam. So we have to, whenever there is a choice between pleasing people and pleasing Allah Azza wa Jal, please go for pleasing your Lord, because that is our ultimate destination, to Him, not to the people. And aap yakin kare, this is a tried and tested stuff. Aap jitni bhi had tak chale jaye logon ko please karne mein, aap unko please nahi kar sakte. Aap unke religion mein convert ho jaye, aap unko please nahi kar sakte. क्योंकि उनके हाथ में कोई पावर नहीं है, कोई कुछ आपको नफा पहुंचाए या आपको नुकसान पहुंचाए. द अल्टीमेट पावर लाइज इन द हैंड्स ऑफ अल्लाह अज़्ज़ा वजल, एंड वी कैन नॉट कॉम्प्रोमाइज इन मैटर्स ऑफ दीन, नो मैटर हाउ एवर दे विल फील बैड और वट एवर द पीपल अराउंड यू. योर टारगेट एंड योर गोल इज टू सीक द प्लेजर ऑफ अल्लाह सुभान व तआला. मेक दिस थिंग वेरी क्लियर, रिमाइंड योर सेल्फ, प्रैक्टिस दिस एंड continuously stay firm on it and make dua for it. It's not you who will be able to do all this, it will be Him. He has to give you that power, that hidayah, that tawfiq to keep your feet firm on the religion. Ya muqallib al-qulub thabbit qalbi ala deena, keep on repeating such masnoon duas to keep your heart firm on His deen. Another verse from surah number 18, verse 21. Just typing the verse in the surah. Okay, what it says. Said those who prevailed in the matter, verily we shall build a place of worship over them. Those who prevailed in the matter, those of influence who forced their opinion after the death of the companion of the cave and decided to take their grave as a place of worship. आपको पता होगा सूरह कहफ में भी जो केव है, ओके, अस्हाबुल कहफ उन्हें कहते हैं ना, तो उस जगह को भी, उनकी ग्रेव को एज अ प्लेस ऑफ वर्शिप. यानी ये जो सिलसिला है ना कि ग्रेव्स को एज अ प्लेस ऑफ वर्शिप लिया जाए, पुराना सिलसिला है. और पता नहीं क्यों इंसान की इसमें अकीदत बहुत ज्यादा है, बाई डिफॉल्ट आई थिंक इट्स इन द फितरा आई गेस, क्योंकि वो अपने आप को स्टॉप ही नहीं कर पाते. बार 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 सेम शिर्क रिपीट होता जा रहा है हिस्ट्री से, पूरा स्टार्ट से लेकर एंड तक. एंड पीपल आर नॉट स्टॉपिंग देयर, दे आर कंटिन्यूसली गेटिंग इनटू इट, डीपर एंड डीपर एंड डीपर. एंड एक जनरेशन उसको बिगिन करती है, दूसरी जनरेशन उसको इग्नोरेंस और ला इल्मी में और आगे ले जाती है, यानी वो शिर्क का जो दरवाजा है वो खुलता ही जाता है, किसी ना किसी की बेवकूफी से वो खुलता ही जाता है, लोग उस गड्ढे में, उस खाई में, उस आग जलती खाई में गिरते जाते हैं. This verse indicates that some of the Muslims nation will build masjids at the grave of the righteous, just as the previous nations used to do. ये जो मैंने आपको दो होमवर्क के क्वेश्चंस दिए हैं ना, एक तो विजिटिंग ताजमहल और दूसरा विजिटिंग करबला. यानी इफ यू आई हैव विजिटेड अ लॉट ऑफ प्लेस, जब पता नहीं था एंड इट वाज इन माय कोर्स ऑफ ट्रैवल एंड टूरिज्म मैनेजमेंट, सो आई हैव विजिटेड लॉट ऑफ ग्रेव्स, मे अल्लाह फॉरगिव अस, बट उस वक्त हमको मालूम नहीं होता, बट यू विल नॉट बी अवेयर के ये जो मॉन्यूमेंट्स हैं, हिस्टोरिकल मॉन्यूमेंट्स हैं, ये ज़्यादातर ग्रेव्स होती हैं. ये ग्रेव्स होती हैं या तो किसी प्रोमिनेंट हिस्टोरियन की, या फिर जिन्होंने बिल्ड किया है, जो आर्टिस्ट्स और जो वर्कर्स, जो लेबर्स होते हैं. पुराने ज़माने में बहुत अजीबोगरीब कल्चर हुआ करता था कि जो आर्टिस्ट ने एक बहुत खूबसूरत मॉन्यूमेंट बना दिया है, सो टू कीप इट एज एन ओरिजिनल पीस, ताकि उस किस्म की कोई डुप्लीकेट पीस ना बना सके वो, सो दे विल कट द हैंड्स ऑफ. इफ यू रिमेम्बर मुगल हिस्ट्री में भी हमने ये पढ़ा हुआ है, दे यूज टू कट द हैंड्स ऑफ एंड मेक देयर टोम एज अ सिग्नेचर, के भाई दिस इज द आर्टिस्ट हु क्रिएटेड दिस मास्टरपीस. सो इस तरीके की बहुत सारी चीजें हैं कि एनी मॉन्यूमेंट, एनी हिस्टोरिक प्लेस यू विल गो, यू विल फाइंड दैट अल्टीमेटली इट्स अ ग्रेव ऑफ सम पर्सन. Now for us, it becomes really difficult. Yes, Jumana. Yes, Jumana. Unmute yourself.
Okay. Just say your question. Is it permissible to visit Karbala or Taj Mahal?
Yeah.
Then okay, we go to visit Masjid al-Nabawi. Yani apni Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam ki कब्र है वहां पे, सो देन हाउ इज इट डिफरेंट.
यस्टरडे वी डिस्कस्ड अ लॉट, अगेन आई रिपीट एंड क्लेरिफाई दिस. सी मस्जिद अन नबवी इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम प्रॉफिट मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम्स ग्रेव, बट ड्यूरिंग वन ऑफ द एक्सपेंशन प्रोग्राम्स, वन ऑफ द शेख्स डिड दैट विदाउट लिसनिंग टू द स्कॉलर्स. यानी उनको मना किया गया था कि आप जो है इनकी ग्रेव को, प्रॉफिट मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम की ग्रेव को मस्जिद में इंक्लूड ना करें, लेकिन ही डिड दैट, एंड दैट इज द रीजन व्हाई दिस पीपल हु विजिट द ग्रेव्स ऑफ अदर पायस पीपल एंड अदर प्रोफेट्स, दे गिव दिस रीजनिंग, बट ओरिजिनली इट इज नॉट अ पार्ट ऑफ मस्जिद. योर इंटेंशन हैज टू बी, जैसे एज पर दैट वन ऑफ द हदीथ व्हिच आई कोटेड अर्लियर, थ्री मसाजिद्स वी आर सपोज टू ट्रैवल, Masjid al-Haram, Masjid al-Nabawi, and Masjid al-Aqsa in Jerusalem. Now, our intention is not to visit Prophet's grave. Our intention is to visit Masjid al-Nabawi. And we are not praying in the sanctity of the graveyard. Instead, we are praying in Masjid al-Nabawi. We have clear indications, clear verses of hadith explaining that it is forbidden to take graves as places of worship. So it is just a change of perception and understanding. And we cannot take this justification because scholars, the salafs, the pious people have time and again passed a fatwa that it is not, the grave of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is not supposed to be included in the masjid. It was mistakenly included by one of the sheikhs who was into the expansion program. But the scholars have refuted that it is not in the part of the masjid. So that is our point of belief. We are not going with the justification that since Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam's grave is in the Masjid al-Nabawi, we are allowed to visit the graves of other prophets. Example, we can go to Karbala and all these places. No, we cannot. We are not allowed. Because once a thing has been established, we cannot supersede it by giving our own justification. This is kind of our own justification, but we have n number of hadith and verdicts which is against it, right?
Are you okay? Yes, I understood.
Now this is a very strong point, and sometimes I feel that this is also a part of qadar. This because one of the sheikhs going against the scholars of his time and doing something which has actually which is one of the trials, I think, for the generations, coming generations, to use that as a justification. And subhanallah, they are using this as a justification. So it is a kind of a trial for us. May Allah protect us and give us daya and keep us firm. Because believe me, ye ek azmaish ka nukta choda gaya hai. कि देखा जाए कि कौन से बंदे इसको सही चीज को पकड़ेंगे और कौन से बंदे इससे भटक जाएंगे. तो हम लोगों को ये सारी चीजों से बचना है और इसी का नाम जो है तकवा है. इसी का नाम जो है कि होल्डिंग ऑन टू द रिलीजन, होल्डिंग ऑन टू द रिलीजन ऑफ मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम एंड होल्डिंग ऑन टू द कुरान एंड होल्डिंग ऑन टू द सुन्ना. सो जस्ट बी वेरी वेरी केयरफुल अबाउट दिस, राइट?
इंशाल्लाह. ओके, जज़ाकअल्लाह खैर.
So Allah exalted be He denounced those who forced their opinion after the death of the companions of the cave and decided to take the grave as a place of worship so that people would pray and seek the blessings of the deceased buried there. Again, वहाँ पर pray करने का हमने कल भी discuss किया था कि what is the point of building a place of worship near the grave is to seek blessings of the deceased. अब ये बात भी गलत हो गई ना, ये तो खुला खुला फिर शिर्क हो गया. कि what is it in that place? What is it with that dead person? Nothing, absolutely nothing. Then why, even if you have to pray Allah Azza wa Jal, why you have to pray there? There is nothing that you can get extra. In fact, you're doing totally against the command of Allah Azza wa Jal and Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So instead of gaining blessings, you are gaining the anger. So, all right, sorry. So, in one of the hadith, Abu Sayyid narrated that Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "You will certainly follow the way of those who were before you, just as the father of an arrow is equal to another feather. So much so that if they entered the hole of a lizard, you all would also enter it." They said, "O Messenger of Allah, are they the Jews and the Christians?" He replied, "Who else?" I'm sure we have read this hadith because this is quite famous. The pillars of this particular concept rest upon this hadith, as every disbelief and shirk that occurred in the previous nation will occur in this ummah also. Follow the same path of the people who were before you and do the same acts. You will certainly, this is following as omitted oath. Walahi latabi unna. Why did the Prophet ﷺ swear an oath here? Again, words, strong words like curse or swearing an oath, it emphasizes the matter that this ummah is also going to follow the way of those who were before them of previous nation. This is a warning against doing so. And this is what precisely is happening. And as I said, we don't know till when. But may Allah protect us and our loved ones from this. What does "just as the feather of an arrow is equal to another feather" mean? There is no difference between one feather and the other feather of the arrow. Arrow mein jo, teer mein jo feathers hote hain, wo ek jaisa hota hai, dusra identically takriban hota hai. So even if they did strange, trivial or harmful things, Muslims will blindly follow and do the exact sins what they were doing. This hadith proves that acts of shirk are committed by some people in Muslim nation as they used to be committed by people of the previous nation. Thus, there will be in the Muslim nation some people who will follow the footsteps of the previous nations who committed such grave sins. The hadith is a proof of the prophethood of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as he foretold what would happen long after his death. And as we all know, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't have any ghaib ilm. He only had the knowledge which Allah azza wa jal gave him. So it is one of the proof of the prophethood, because prophets will be given the knowledge through Allah, and that is only the prophets who have this ability. So this is a proof, that proof of his prophethood. Because this incident or this particular thing that he's talking about is going to happen after his death, so he's foretelling this. And this occurred exactly as the Prophet ﷺ maintained. Muslims are warned against the sins committed by the previous nations and against imitating them. Some might say, this ummah is safe from falling into major shirk. This is due to the Prophet's hadith. Verily, Shaitan has given us hope that those who pray would worship him in the Arabian Peninsula, but he only hopes for discord among them. There is no doubt that those who pray are commanders of good and forbidders of evil. And the greatest evil that the person prays will reject is shirk. For verily, Shaitan gives us hope that one who established the prayer in its true manner will ever worship Shaitan. Therefore, we say this hadith does not mention that the worship of Shaitan will not occur in this ummah. It only says that Shaitan is desperate that those who establish prayer will ever worship him again. This is why shortly after the Prophet ﷺ died, a group of Arabs reverted from Islam, and that was from the worship of Shaitan. So we cannot, what do we mean by this particular hadith is that we cannot confirm ever that I am praying 5 times, so I am safe. You cannot be safe from this particular sin. It is a continuous effort, and you have to, as I say, कभी भी अपनी इबादत या अपनी गुड डीड्स के ऊपर आप भरोसा नहीं करो. यू नेवर नो, एक तो हमारा खात्मा किस हालत में होता है. सो वी हैव टू मेक दोस सर्टेन दुआज विच आई हैड डिस्कस अर्लियर आल्सो, कि अल्लाह से कंटिन्यूस दुआ करना, अल्लाह मनी असर कुल हुस्नुल खात्मा. हमारा जो खात्मा हो या हमें जो इस्तकामत अल्लाह ताला दे कि वी कंटिन्यूसली स्टे ऑन द राइट पाथ, ऑन द राइट दीन. दूसरे नंबर पर, हम कभी भी अपनी गुड डीड्स के ऊपर ज्यादा प्राउड फील ना करें, बिकॉज द मोमेंट वी स्टार्ट डिपेंडिंग ऑन अवर गुड डीड्स एंड स्टार्ट थिंकिंग गुड अबाउट अवर सेल्फ एंड बी लिटलिंग अदर्स, दैट इज वेयर वी विल गो ऑन टू द डाइवर्जन ट्रैक. And may Allah protect us from that, from being judgmental, from being thinking good about ourselves, to be calculative. कि मैं इतनी नेक हूँ, मैंने इतने कुरान पढ़ ली, मैंने इतनी नमाज़ें, इतने सदका कर ली. You never know what is getting accepted or even being done in the right manner. So we are all not safe. Yes, Jumanu.
That will be same like what Iblis was doing.
Exactly. That is the same thing. Yes, जहाँ पर arrogance आ जाए, because हम लोग एक बात आप ज़हन में रखें, हमारी कामयाबी या हमारा रास्ता और our ticket to Jannah does not depend on our good deeds. It depends solely on the pleasure, on the permission, on the will of Allah Azza wa Jal. So हमारा जो concept है कि नेकी कर दरिया में डाल has to be there in our head. कि हम सिर्फ कमांड्स अल्लाह के, हमारे मैसेंजर के सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम के फॉलो करें अच्छी तरह से, उसको अच्छी तरह से अदा करने की कोशिश करें, और उसके बाद हम उसकी गौर फिक्र ना करें कि हमें हमारे अमाल बचाने वाले हैं. दैट इज अ रॉन्ग अप्रोच, टोटली रॉन्ग अप्रोच. आवर आइडिया इज दैट वी डू एवरीथिंग विद इखलास, विद सिंसियर इंटेंशन टू प्लीज अल्लाह अज़्ज़ा वजल ऑन द वे शोड अस बाय आवर मैसेंजर सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम. And the remaining lies in the hands of Allah Azza wa Jal. You can have the hope. You remember we had discussed in level 1, the 3 emotions. Love, fear and hope. Muhabba, khawf and raja. You have to keep that emotions in your head, in your heart, in regards to Allah Azza wa Jal. But you cannot count on your good deeds. Because jitni ne'mate hum Allah Ta'ala ki istemal karte hain din bar mein. From the time hum we were in the mother's womb till we go to our grave, jis tarike ki nemat hai humne jisko manga nahi, jisko humne demand nahi kiya, jisko humne socha nahi, tawakkul nahi kiya, Allah is 24/7 providing it to you free of cost, in spite of your disobedience, in spite of your transgressing his limits, he is continuously providing that. To us lihaz se hamari nekiyan kuch bhi nahi hai, to calculation ka to sawal hi nahi paida hota. Forget about being calculative, but even having that thought might take you astray. So I would say that don't even be calculative and start thinking good about yourself, but be hopeful, but don't start thinking too much of yourself. Be dependent, be humble, be very, very in your actions, in your words, humility is the thing जो छलकनी चाहिए. आजिज़ी आपके हर चीज में, हर शय में छलकनी चाहिए. सो डू दैट एंड देन इंशाल्लाह सीक अल्लाह प्रोटेक्शन एंड यू विल बी सेव्ड बिइज़्निल्लाह. ये सब समझ का फेर होता है. लेकिन आपको ये चीज को बहुत गांठ मार के चलनी है. If you see someone, this is a question now, an open question, huh? If you see someone imitating in clothing, etc., of kafir, what is it? What is your verdict? Ji, did you understand my question? You see someone, a Muslim, imitating a kafir in terms of clothing. What is your verdict?
We should stop them.
We should. No, I'm not saying what will be your action. I'm saying
it's wrong.
It's wrong. In what way, Yani? If you can specify more.
It's the same
we should not
that ki unke tehwar mein nahi jana, the way we are not allowed, the way we should just restrict ourselves. We have been given a proper Islam, proper way of living. Stick to it. Why to keep on differing in their culture or in their dressing or in their religion or in their celebration, anything.
Right. Or koi opinion? Very nice. Iman.
Okay, if we don't do it, that means we are accepting what they are doing. So that's not correct.
Imitating. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Kisi ko imitate karna, yani you are accepting what they are. So fitna failta hai, you know.
Right. So to be jo ek nukta mujhe yahan pe batana tha, jazakallah khair Jumana and Iman, it's like when do you imitate? For example, if you take the teenagers, wo ek particular role model hai, for example koi artist, koi pop star, koi celebrity, usko imitate karta hai in terms of hairstyle ya clothing or some fashion or things like that. You know what does it mean? It means that person is very close in their hearts. Why do a person imitate? Why are we supposed to take Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam as a role model? Because we love him. He is in our hearts and minds and he is overpowering us in our souls. So when somebody takes that place in your heart, that is the point you want to imitate that person in everything. How they sit, how they talk, how they walk, how they dress. So clearly, if somebody is imitating a kafir, that means that person or that thing has taken a place in their heart. Always remember that. That is the reason, I again repeat, it is encouraged that if we believe in Islam, you look like a Muslim, you speak like a Muslim, you walk the talk. For example, I say I am a Muslim, but I dress up contradictory. I am in my tight jeans, tight clothes, no hijab, nothing, body hugging t-shirts. But Islam is in my heart. If I have to pray, I will wear my thobe. Is it matching? No, it's not matching. If I believe in Allah Azza wa Jal, I have to look like I believe in Allah Azza wa Jal. Now again, some might think I'm not doing it for the sake of others. But believe me, wherever you go, whatever you do, like Hazrat Aisha radiallahu anha used to say that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is a talking, walking Quran. Whatever your maamlat is, whatever you are dealing in, it should reflect Islam. Your language, your thought, your choices, your dealings, your actions, your everything A to Z, inside out, should reflect. It should be on the same page. Anywhere if there is a confusion, anywhere if there is any contradicting things happening, definitely aapko jaiza lena padega. Aapko bahut zyada apne aap ka jaiza lena padega ki there is a conflict of interest here. Kahin na kahin jaakar aapke andar, aapke dil ke andar abhi bhi kisi aur gair cheez ki mohabbat baki hai. Aur jab tak ki aap us cheez ko khalis nahi karenge, aapki life confusion mein hi guzregi. And aapki life शायद गुजर भी चुकी हो. द डिपेंडेंस ऑन यू, स्पेशली योर चिल्ड्रन हु आर फॉलोइंग यू अननोइंगली, अनइंटेंशनली, दे विल बी लेफ्ट इन अटर कंफ्यूजन. सो अगेन, टाइम टू कंटेम्पलेट, थिंक अबाउट इट. दिस इज द टाइम, लॉकडाउन पीरियड, रमदान, एन आइडियल सिचुएशन. सिट बैक एंड मेक अ लिस्ट इन योर हेड कि आप वो कौन कौन सी चीजें कर रहे हो गलत. वो गलत चीजों की वो कंफ्यूजन यू आर पासिंग ऑन टू योर किड्स, टू योर चिल्ड्रन. Try to rectify your affairs. May Allah help us. May Allah give us hidayah, ya Rab. But this is the time to contemplate. So if somebody is imitating something or someone, they have taken a place in their heart. Okay, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Allah folded the earth for me and I saw its east and west, and the dominion of my Ummah will reach as far as the earth was folded for me. The two treasures, the red and the white, will be given to me. I invoke my Lord that he may not destroy my Ummah by a widespread famine and not give sovereignty over them to an enemy who destroys them in large numbers, except for themselves. My God said, O Muhammad, whenever I issue a decree, it is not withdrawn. I promise you for your nation that I will not destroy it by a widespread famine, and I will not give sovereignty over them to an enemy, not from among themselves, who exterminates them in large numbers, even if all the people from the different parts of the world join hands against them, unless they kill each other and take one another as captives. Very beautiful and a very thought-provoking hadith, actually. Al-Barqani recorded the same narration. He added that the Prophet ﷺ said, I fear for my ummah the misleading imams, the rulers, and if they are afflicted with using the sword among themselves, killing each other, it will not be removed from them until the day of resurrection. The hour will not establish until a drive of my ummah follows the mushriks and group of my ummah worship idols. There will be 30 liars in my ummah, each one claiming that he is a prophet. Though I am the seal of the prophets, no prophet will come after me, but a group of my ummah will always hold the truth, remain triumphant, and cannot be harmed by their opponents until there comes the command of Allah Azza wa Jal, blessed and exalted be he. Very detailed hadith. Actually, we'll try to discuss that, and this will be the last hadith of the day. But the things that gives me a stir in my heart is that even though, I mean, now the first part of the hadith was the dialogue between Allah Azza wa Jal and Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Allah Azza wa Jal literally folded the earth and showed Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam ki unki jo dominion hai, unki jo ummah hai, wo kahan se kahan tak spread hogi. It was like a real huge place, and now you can see it happening. Like this hadith is very relevant in today's time. Ke Muslims, every fourth person walking on this face of earth is Muslim, and it is increasing by leaps and bounds. Subhanallah, it is increasing. And then Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is again seeking some protection, ki famine or ye sab cheezon se barbaad na ho. And Allah Azza wa Jal is giving him that promise. Ke no matter, even if the world join hands together, they cannot destroy. Unless the two cheez batai hai, jo really gives me this thing. Ke if the Muslims themselves are becoming enemies of each other, if they are taking captives, and that is what is happening, that is the core reason of why we are losing. Because Muslims ke dushman ho rahe. The second part says, okay, even if somebody is trying, even if the world stand against the Muslim Ummah, it cannot break them unless a particular sect of the Ummah is following the Mushrik. And is Ummah mein se log, anauzu billah astaghfirullah azim, idols ki worship bhi karenge. Ab idols, we know, we're talking about graves. We are literally talking about graves and other idols, literally what people are worshipping, dead people and deceased and things like that. Uske baad, there is a mention of 30 liars. We know about this. I don't know if you, some of you might not be aware, but it has been predicted, and which is true, almost 30 aise liars aayenge, jo ke apne aapko claim karenge ke they are the prophets. Wo Mahdi alayhi salam hone ka dawa karenge, wo apna nabi hone ka dawa karenge, aur unki badi buri tarah se maut hui hai. Yani, if you want to just Google it, you can check the stories of Ahmadi. Ke unki maut kaisi hui thi, and he declared himself as a prophet. So there are many such people who claimed prophethood, aur unka bada buri tarah se khatma hua hai. Because khatmun nabi is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Unke baad koi nahi hai. Of course, Isa alayhi salam and Mahdi alayhi salam ka jo time aayega, that's a different account, but not in terms of having messengers and nabi after Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Ab isme sabse bada nukta jo hai, jisme jo bahut inspire aur encouraging hai, wo hai, but a group of my ummah will always hold the truth. Yani ek particular group jo hai, wo hamesha sachai par, haq par, sahi raste par rahega. वो opponents उसको harm नहीं कर पाएंगे. And they are the people who will be holding that flag. May Allah include us among those. May Allah include us among the true believers of the religion. May Allah include us among those जो कि बिना हिसाब किताब के जन्नत में दाखिल हों. अल्लाह उनसे राजी हो जाए यार. तो ये वो कैटेगरी है जो हमारा गोल है फाइनली इंशाल्लाह यार. तो इसके लिए जद्दोजहद करनी है, इसके लिए दुआ मांगनी है, इसके लिए स्ट्रगल करना है. बिकॉज दिस इज द रियल टेस्टिंग टाइम्स. सो अल्लाह फोल्डेड द अर्थ, अल्लाह डिस्प्लेड द अर्थ टू प्रोफेट मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम इनटू अ कॉम्पैक्ट साइज एंड एनेबल्ड हिम टू सी द डोमिनियन ऑफ हिज नेशन. यानी फॉर अस नाउ इन दिस टेक्नोलॉजिकल वर्ल्ड इट्स वेरी इजी टू फिगर आउट कि एक पर्टिकुलर जो हमें किसी चीज की जगह देखनी है एंड सम रेज आर कमिंग इन एंड द एंटायर थिंग इज इन फ्रंट ऑफ अस. फॉर अल्लाह इट इज जस्ट अ मैटर ऑफ कुन. इट इज पॉसिबल बिकॉज विद द ह्यूमन टेक्नोलॉजी वी कैन सी इट राइट नाउ. जस्ट अ फिंगर टिप एंड वी कैन सी विद द गूगल सैटेलाइट एनी वेयर वॉट एवर वी वॉन्ट. सो इमेजिन द क्रिएटर ही फोल्डेड द एंटायर थिंग मेड इट कॉम्पैक्ट एंड शोड मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम हाउ हिज डोमिनियन विल बी. द रेड ट्रेजर एंड व्हाइट ट्रेजर व्हाट इज इट. The former referred to gold. It belonged to Caesar, the king of Romans. The latter consisted of diamond and silver and belonged to the king of Persians. So, yani sari jo major dominions thi, uske upar bhi Islam will be havi. So, Allah Ta'ala give the indication ki kahan se kahan tak aur kaun si dominion se kahan se dominion tak uska pura jo Islam ka jo phailna hoga, wo kahan tak hoga. If they are afflicted with using the sword among themselves, in case they fall a prey to dissension, killing and conflict, which is definitely there. We are seeing what's happening in Syria, in Yemen, in Iraq, in Afghanistan, in all the places where Muslim nations are there, there is bloodshed happening. They're killing each other. What is meant by misleading imams? Rulers, scholars and devoted worshippers who are usually taken as models by common people. I keep saying that okay, you should be very sure and make sure you're children also have the right role model. Because agar hamare role model humne galat pick up kar liye, we are doomed. We are totally doomed. Like I don't like to again comment on a particular community or a sect, but we all know very well ke koi sayyidna, koi sheikh, koi ulama, koi maulvi, jis jo अपने अकीदे में, अपनी टीचिंग्स में, अपने अमल और इल्म में सही नहीं है, लोग ब्लाइंडली फॉलो कर रहे हैं उनको. दे आर मेकिंग हिम अ तागूत एंड फॉलोइंग एंड अगेन वो एक गड्ढे की तरफ अपने आप को ले जा रहे हैं. मैं अल्लाह प्रोटेक्ट अस यार. व्हाट इज मेंट बाय अंटिल देयर कम्स द कमांड ऑफ अल्लाह. द कमांड ऑफ अल्लाह रिफर्स टू द नाइस विंड व्हिच विल ब्लो इमीडिएटली बिफोर द डे ऑफ रिसरेक्शन. It will take the souls of the believers. As we all are aware, and if some of us are not aware, जब डे ऑफ रिसरेक्शन आएगा तो उसकी हौलनाकियों को बिलीवर्स जो अच्छे बिलीवर्स हैं वो एक्सपीरियंस ना करें तो अल्लाह अज़्ज़ा वजल विल एक हवा चलेगी. इट विल ब्लो एंड दैट ब्लो विल टेक द सोल्स ऑफ द गुड बिलीवर्स. ठीक है, ताकि उनको हौलनाकियां एक्सपीरियंस करना ना पड़े. एंड व्हाट इज मेंट बाय अ ट्राइब फ्रॉम द उम्मा जॉइंस द पॉलीथीस्ट्स. दिस कुड हैपन बाय अबैंडनिंग द लैंड्स ऑफ इस्लाम. अभी ये पॉइंट्स जो है ना बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. आई नो वी हैव reached 3 o'clock, but then I want to clear this hadith. It is very important and certain points for us as a takeaway lesson. In the hadith there is a line which says a tribe from my ummah will join the mushriks. Ab ye kon kon se points hai hamare liye isme lesson hai. This could happen by abandoning the lands of Islam, yani Islam ki land ko chhod kar mushrik ki land mein jana, going to the lands of the mushrik, being pleased with them and their religion. It could also mean in reference to characteristics. Hence, they would follow and imitate them, committing shirk just as they committed shirk even while staying in the lands of Islam. Masalan, wo log jo mushrik se, mushrik ke religion se, unki land se, unke tarike se influence hoke, ya to unki land mein migrate kar gaye, ya phir apne Islamic land mein rehte hue bhi unko imitate kar gaye. So, ये दोनों चीजें से वार्निंग है. ये दोनों चीजें हमारे लिए खतरनाक है. ये हमारे लिए एक इशारा, एक साइन है. मे अल्लाह प्रोटेक्ट अस. व्हाट इज मेंट बाय देयर विल ऑलवेज बी अ ग्रुप फ्रॉम माय उम्मा हु विल होल्ड टू द ट्रुथ. ये है वो हमारा आइडियल ग्रुप. दिस ग्रुप हैज बीन नेम्ड ताइफा मंसूरा, विक्टोरियस ग्रुप, बिकॉज Allah Azza wa Jal will aid it against whoever struggles against it with proofs and evidences. ठीक है, this aid and victory is not referring to the war. ये war वाली situation नहीं है, लेकिन आपको पता है अपना jihad, अपना struggle जो है वो खुद एक war है in itself. For even though they may be beaten in some battles, they are victorious and aided by what Allah Azza wa Jal has given them of proofs and evidences and truth against others besides them. For they are upon the truth and others besides them are upon falsehood. यानी अब ये evidences जो है, it means Quran and Sunnah. They are holding on to that. And that is what we are trying to achieve. That is why I keep repeating, gain knowledge, stitch. अपने आप को कहते हैं, stick to Quran. Stick to Quran. Stick to knowledge, the right knowledge. And continuously hold on each other. एक दूसरे की इस्लाह करते हैं, पकड़ के हाथ चले, इंशाल्लाह अल्लाह की मदद आएगी. Some among the Muslim nations commit acts of shirk which refutes the allegation of those who claim otherwise. The Prophet ﷺ foretold some events that have already come true, which is a clear proof of his prophethood. We have seen that. We are seeing it, in fact. The Prophet ﷺ had deep sympathy towards his nation. Muslims are greatly warned against discord and devious leaders. This hadith gives two glad tidings. Firstly, the truth cannot be completely overcome. And secondly, a group of Muslims remains steadfast in adherence to Islam without being affected by whoever opposes or fights them until the day of judgment. Yani, do khushkhabriyan hain. Ek, ke truth jo hai, wo kabhi bhi usko falsehood overcome nahi karega. Chahe jo bhi ho jaye, chahe kitni bhi taqatein jod jaye. Dusra, ek group of Muslims jo hain, jo taifa mansura hai, which is the victorious group, wo day of judgment tak बना रहेगा. सो सुभान अल्लाह, जहां पर गलत चीजों का गलबा होगा वहां पर ये हैंडफुल ऑफ ट्रुथफुल लोग इंशाल्लाह ताला विल बी टेकिंग दैट, कहते हैं ना वो मशाल लेकर जा रहे होंगे अकीदा तौहीद की. सो दैट इज आवर टारगेट. मे अल्लाह मेक अस अमंग दोस जो कि चोजन हो, जो कि ऑन द राइट दीन हो, जिनके कामयाबी जो है वो अल्लाह ताला डिक्लेयर करे और उनसे प्लीज हो जाए. एंड दिस इज आवर अल्टीमेट गोल एंड अल्टीमेट विक्ट्री. May Allah make us among those. May Allah make us among the Muqarrabin, Ya Rab, and forgive us. Okay, guys, any questions? It's already 6 minutes up. Let's talk about any questions, any discussion, open forum.
Nasreen, nothing, alhamdulillah, nothing regarding this topic. Just wanted to ask, if every year this confusion is there, ki, 20th, today is 19th Roza. So, Maghrib se तीसवा रोजा शुरू हो जाएगा तो खयाम शुड स्टार्ट टुडे, राइट?
खयाम शुड स्टार्ट टुडे. एक्चुअली इट इज द ऑड नाइट की ईव कही जाती है ना, तो कल की होगी.
सो द खयाम इज दैट मींस फ्रॉम 21st टिल 29th.
इट इज द 20th
ईव. इट्स नॉट 10
रातें. नहीं, एक्चुअली 20th की रात जो होगी वो 21st की ईव होगी ना.
हां,
इट इज ऑलवेज द ईव. इट इज ऑलवेज द ईव. सो 21st की ईव कौन सी होगी? 20th की नाइट.
मतलब कल शाम, कल मगरिब के बाद.
लेकिन लेकिन हम लोगों ने जैसे पहले भी इस चीज के बारे में डिस्कस किया था, शायद इस ग्रुप में या कुरान तफसीर के ग्रुप में, कि हम लोगों की कोशिश इस, क्योंकि अभी सब लॉकडाउन की हालत है, सारे घर पर ही हैं, सारे नफरत. सो मेक श्योर कि आप जो है वो पूरा सिर्फ ये लास्ट के 10 नाइट्स को ही कयाम ना करें, पूरे 30 नाइट्स को कयाम करें.
ये जो क्वेश्चन था अगेन, permissible on visiting Taj Mahal and this. You said you want some evidences or some, because
you justify your आप जो भी बात करेंगे ना उसको justify करें. Like I always say, being students of अकीदा ना, आप कोई भी बात करेंगे ना तो उसको आपको जस्टिफाई करना है. सिर्फ एक स्टेटमेंट आप नहीं देंगे, इट्स नॉट एन आंसर इन वन सेंटेंस. समवेयर डाउन द लाइन यू हैव टू गिव सम एविडेंस, सम जस्टिफिकेशन ऑफ व्हाई यू वुड से इट इज परमिसेबल और नॉट परमिसेबल.
ओके,
या सो थोड़ा सा जस्टिफाई करें. यू कैन ऑल्सो, यानी आप जस्टिफिकेशन के साथ अपनी पर्सनल ओपिनियन भी एड कर सकते हैं, बट आई जस्ट डोंट वॉन्ट योर पर्सनल ओपिनियन, आई वॉन्ट द एविडेंसेस.
ओके, इंशाल्लाह.
चैलेंज ये जरूर करना है. दूसरा ये कि अगर कोई और सवाल, कोई डाउट हो, कुछ हो, तो आप ग्रुप में डालें. जैसे कल सदफ ने पूछा था, आई वाज वेरी हैप्पी शी आस्क्ड दैट क्वेश्चन, बिकॉज दैट इज अ वेरी कॉमन प्रैक्टिस ऑफ पुटिंग प्लांटिंग पॉट्स एंड थिंग्स लाइक दैट, कि भाई ग्रीन डालो, ग्रीन रहेगा तो वो नेके आएंगे. एंड आई एम श्योर यू, आप लोगों ने अगर नहीं पढ़ा है तो प्लीज गो बैक एंड रीड इन द ग्रुप. आई हैड गिवन द कंप्लीट जस्टिफिकेशन देयर कि हाउ द परसेप्शन कैन चेंज. इट इज अबाउट द जिक्र दैट इज ग्लोरिफाइंग, इट इज नॉट अबाउट द स्टॉक, अबाउट द ग्रीन लीफ. सो ये सब चीजें जो है, इट्स जस्ट अ मैटर ऑफ अंडरस्टैंडिंग. बहुत बारीकी वाली चीजें हैं ये, लेकिन जब आप इसके परसेप्शन समझ जाते हो तो आपके सामने कंसेप्ट क्लियर हो जाता है. तो जितना आप पढ़ेंगे, जितना अल्लाह से दुआ करेंगे, उतनी फहम आपकी बढ़ेगी, अंडरस्टैंडिंग बढ़ेगी. ठीक है, और कोई क्वेश्चन होगा तो डेफिनेटली पुट इट इन द ग्रुप, वी विल डिस्कस, विल ट्राई टू फाइंड आउट. बट स्टे फर्म पीपल, अकीदा तौहीद इज अवर गोल. स्टे फर्म, थिंग्स आर वेरी डिफिकल्ट एंड टाइम्स आर वेरी टफ राइट नाउ, बट स्टे फर्म एंड अल्लाह विल डेफिनेटली हेल्प यू. ओके, سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد ان لا اله الا انت نستغفرك ونتوب اليك. السلام عليكم ورحمه الله وبركاته.